Hi guys, Baron here, and today we are going to learn about breeding. Now, the first thing that I want to show you guys, because it is a precursor to breeding, it's required in order to breed, we're going to start off, we're going to talk about Smeargle, which there are other Pokemon that serve the purpose of Smeargle just as well. It just seems like Smeargle is a good choice because it can learn literally any move you want to teach it and that you feel will serve a benefit to your catching. So, Smeargle is useful because it has the move False Swipe, which, as it says, a restrained attack that always leaves the foe with at least 1 HP, meaning you can't kill anything, which is awesome for trying to catch low-level Pokemon. So, you use False Swipe, you also have the ability Spore that puts them to sleep. I have on mine Sweet Scent just for hordes, because it's a utility Pokemon for me. Odor Sleuth makes it so that Pokemon that would otherwise be immune to abilities are no longer immune to those abilities. For example, Normal Type, immunity with Ghastly, that you can't hit Ghastly with a Normal Type. This makes it so you can, since False Swipe is a Normal Type. That's important to note. So essentially, we're going to have that as our lead Pokemon. However, one thing that's important to note is that if you're after a particular nature of Pokemon, you can take an Abra or other Pokemon. I think it's basically just Abra, although there might be others, with Synchronize, and essentially if I were to use this Abra, which has the ability Synchronize, then I would have a 15% chance to catch Pokemon that are careful. Given that I'm not actually trying to catch breeders right now, because I already have a ton of them, you'll see later in the video, I was doing exactly what I'll be showing you guys for a very long time, and I no longer need specific natures. I've got everything that I need to finish my breed. So, essentially, that will just increase the likelihood that a wild Pokemon you encounter will be the nature that you want. It's a pretty simple solution, and it works. So you can use that for catching competitions, you can use that for catching a specific Pokemon that you want. It's just a good thing, and the nice thing is that you can have, say, a level 1 Abra in your first slot, and you can take it to a level 50 zone, kill it, keep it in the first slot of your party, and then put Smeargle in the second slot, and it'll still work, even though it's dead. So that is a very useful tip. I would demonstrate that, but I think you can try it yourself, and it works, trust me. Okay, so we're going to ride over to these fields where I believe Tay will be riding around. There he is! Hey, it's Tay Pepito! Tay Pepito is also farming Smeargle. Look at that. First one we encounter is a Smeargle. That's why this place is so good. Now, given that we encounter Pokemon of different genders, I should tell you a little bit about what the genders do in breeding. The female, you see that little red symbol? You probably figured out that does something in this game. What it does is it says it's female. And when you're breeding, the female decides what the breed will make. As in, if you breed a female Abra with a male Spinda, you will get an Abra. If you breed a male Abra with a female Spinda, you will get a Spinda. That's how it works. So when you're breeding up your chain, specifically what I refer to as the side chain, the natured Pokemon, that's always going to be holding the Everstone, which I'll explain later. Don't worry about that for now if you're unfamiliar. Don't get overwhelmed. I'll take my time. I will ease you into this crazy stuff. There's a reasonable amount to know, but mostly it's just, you know, practice and memorization, essentially. So, essentially what we're going to do is we're going to start with a False Swipe, and we're gonna knock it down to 1 HP. it's gonna do some sort of move on us in response, and then we throw a Pokeball at it. That's it. As simple as that. We are done. It is captured. So let's hope it's got a 31 so I can also show you naming. That would be useful. Either way, I'll show you that. So if, say for example, even though this one isn't as good as we would like it to be, we would like ideally a 31 stat. What we would do is we would name it. Say we have a 31 HP. I literally name them all what their stats are. So now this will go to my box and be named 31 HP. However, right now, I'm gonna release it. So the way you release is starting from this screen that pops up, only when your party is full does this work. You get a new option on the right side of your bar right there. It's release Pokemon. Confirm release, it's gone. No need to worry about it. Okay, now we're flying over to Mauville. Squirty is trying to participate in the video. We're gonna ride on over, and this is the Hoenn location of the breeders. This guy is the actual breeder. You trade him the Pokemon you intend to breed, and he will take them after a little while, sometimes instantly, actually. He will give you back an egg, and then after a little while, you wait, that egg will hatch, and you are done. Okay, so now we're going to go inside this building. This woman here sells braces and all of that stuff. So these braces, what they do is they lock in a stat, okay? And I'll explain that more once I've got the screen up. So, the ability pill we won't worry about right now, that changes the special ability. Say a Skarmory, you could get either the one that makes it so you can't lose accuracy or something like that, or Sturdy. And those are the two possible abilities for it. And you change that with the ability pill. It's 35,000, a little expensive, but that's okay. So what we're going to do, I want to breed a Torchic. I want a Blaziken. So I'm going to go on GTL because I was trying to catch one myself, but I didn't manage. What is this one for 21,000? It's not really... Yeah, I don't like it. Not worth the money in my mind. So let's see these two for 9,000, because pretty much right now, I don't care what it is that I'm getting. I actually don't care, because I'm going to be breeding with a Ditto first thing. So, you know, what's the difference for me? So I'll go ahead and buy this one, which let me figure out which one that is. So it's this top one. Let's go ahead and buy it. So it's 9,000, not too bad of a price. Let's go ahead and pick it up from the mailbox. Okay, and first of all, we need to make space, and I will, I'll go ahead and make space, and I'll show you a little trick that's useful for this purpose, for breeding. If you notice, I'm keeping a Slugma in my party, and the reason is that when Slugma is in the first slot of your party, it will put on Flame Body. And Flame Body, although I think it goes by different names, what Flame Body does is it makes it so that it grows your eggs faster. Your eggs hatch faster than they otherwise would. So we're gonna grab out a Ditto with Adamant, because that's what I would like first. Adamant. And let's see these Dittos. I want one with not great stats, because literally all we're using it for is the nature. That's it. So, let's just check through. And you see how useful it is, just that search feature, to be able to just tab, 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 tab. And you can tell from how many Dittos that I have that are Adamant, you can tell that I was running around with a synchronized Adamant Abra in the lead of my party when I was catching those dittos. So I'll just grab this one. Why not? You know, it's not not the most important thing right now. And now we're going to close this mess of windows that I just created. So, yeah, we're going to go ahead, close all of those. And now we grab the Torchic from the mailbox. Claim. And we're going to run out of here, bail out. So the only item that we will currently need is Everstone, which I happen to have in my inventory. I've been farming those. I'll show you where to catch those as well as part of this video. So this will be a very inclusive guide to everything that needs to be done. We got Squirty hopping around with his frog head and his little acro bike. Okay, so first of all, given that we know that this Ditto has the nature we want to keep, that is the one that we equip the Everstone to. So once the Everstone, actually, let me unequip that and first show you the menu, how the menu looks without the Everstone equipped. Okay, so we're gonna say yes, we want to trade, are you sure? And yes. And then this window will pop up where you select your Pokemon. So we're going to select the Torchic, and we're going to select the Ditto. And what you'll notice is obviously they're compatible, because Ditto is really beautiful because it can breed with anything. It can literally breed with any Pokemon that you want. And it's a really nice feature that it's able to do that. So if you look right now on the menu, we have an HP range, which you'll notice is between the mother and the father. So this value will right now be randomly determined between the two. So 4 to 11, 2 to 31, because there's 31 to 5, 24, 25, 22, 30, 26, and then 13, 14. And also you'll notice that the nature is currently a question. That's because right now, no nature is locked. And that means that you have a 1 in 20 chance to hit your nature, but you also have a 19 in 20 chance to hit some other nature. So I'm very much of the school of thought that it's better to be consistent. So I would like to just start off, put the Everstone on, and I will start with a natured Pokemon. So, if you'll notice that when this screen pops up, we're going to select our Torchic, who currently has nothing, and our Ditto. And you will notice that now we have Adamant, guaranteed inheritance due to Everstone. So, that is a very nice feature, and it's just a very useful thing in order to make it so that we can breed. So let's look at what we're doing first. We're doing plus 10% attack and minus 10% SP attack, which is fine. So let's go ahead. Now we wait. Sometimes if you talk to him immediately, sometimes he'll be ready and, you know, your Pokemon were just like, bam, having a baby. Otherwise you'll have to wait. And in the meantime, I can show you guys how to farm Everstones. I probably won't be catching many Everstones, or getting many Everstones, because we won't really have that much time to try and farm them. But I'll at least be able to show you the location, which is another reason it's kind of nice that we're here in Hoenn, because that's where you're going to find the Everstone farm. So we're going to fly to Lava Ridge, right here. Flying out. I'm gonna bike up, and for this, notably, you need the Acro Bike in order to do this. You stand in place and hold the B button, which in my case, and by default, is the X button. And you'll start hopping, and then you can ride up, and you're going to go in this cave here. And you're just going to ride around, and when you encounter a Geodude or a Graveler, you're going to thief it. Which currently I have, as you can see, a Quagsire, which Quagsire's ability is Damp, which prevents self-destruction. So in the event of a shiny Geodude, we have the ability to potentially catch it and at least stop it from blowing itself up. So the other thing is Thief, which steals the held item of a Pokemon if it has one. And the only drawback there is that the Pokemon with Thief has to have an empty inventory before you use it. So let's hope for some crazy RNG, and in the like 2 minutes that we're gonna spend here, that we'll get an Everstone so I can demonstrate. You know, maybe the RNG gods will smile upon this video. Although it's unlikely. But Everstones are like 20,000, something like that. So, you know, it's definitely not a bad thing if you get one. Yeah, you can see 19,500 is the cheapest right now. So we're going to go ahead and use our Quagsire a couple times. And ideally, we would get one. But I'm not going to stay too much longer, because I don't want to, you know, spend the whole video just running around trying to get a friggin' Everstone when I already have enough to start the video. And the main thing is that I just want to show you the start of breeding, and then I'll show you how we make our calculations. So I'm going to go ahead and bail out. So it is a little annoying that sometimes you can't escape from Graveler here, which kind of stinks, because then they can use Magnitude, which Magnitude is definitely the one that hurts the most out of their ability set. Rock Throw doesn't really hurt that much. They can't self-destruct, and Harden doesn't hurt at all. Magnitude can hurt, especially if it's like a Magnitude 10. It can take like a good, you know, third of your HP, even with an over-leveled Pokemon. So now we're going to fly back to Mauville. And for those of you that don't know, just so that you do now, here's the PC. We're just going to ride straight left, and we've got the breeder. Let's see if our egg is ready. Hey, it is! Now, important, remember that I said the female decides the species, okay? So that means we have to hit yes, and we have to hit female. And get ready for this, because if you look up, Torchic Bulbapedia, we're gonna go ahead and pull up the Bulbapedia for Torchic. And you will see that it's 12.5% female, which means he's gonna charge quite a lot extra for a female Pokemon. If it were the other way around, he would charge less. Usually, if it's 50-50, you pay 5,000. But here, I think we're going to be paying, 21,000, just to keep it female. And unfortunately, we don't have a choice in this. Throw it in a Pokeball, and now we've got our egg. So, eggs are entirely time-based. So we literally just wait around, and in the meantime, I can explain some things to you. So, In my inventory here, my storage box, you can see that if I look up 31 ATK, because I've been naming them this whole time, I can easily find, oh hey, that one has 31 attack, that one has 31 attack. Some of them, I changed how I was writing it. I used to write 31 ATT, so I have to check a couple times, just checking through my stock. That's it. So, you can do that with all of my breeders, because I made sure that I could do that, because it helps a lot just to be able to quickly tab through, and you can find all of the compatible breeders that you need. Now, what I've done in order to make this breeding make sense to you and to me, I have labeled everything by letter. Letter is easier for me to remember personally, and it might work for you. You might have your own different system. Essentially, HP is A, attack is B, defense is C, special attack is D, then special defense is E, and then speed is F. It's just in the order of the stats, A, B, C, D, E, F. It's very simple. And then the red is female and the blue is male, because for breeding, it's important. You gotta know how many compatible breeding pairs you have. And as you can see, I've got quite a lot of breeders. I spent quite a long time farming them. So we're going to use this menu. And if you note over here, we've got CF, AC, CF, AC, AD, AE. Those are 2x31s, and we can use those later on in order to continue our breeding. So we've got probably about 75 1x31s and another 6 2x31s. Now, just some important numbers to remember is that each time that you breed, you will require twice as many breeders. So in order to get a 131, 1 × 31, obviously you don't have to breed it with anything, so that requires one. And then in order to get a 2x31, you've got to breed a 1x31 with a 1x31 both braced, and you get a 2x31. It costs two breeders. Now if you want to get a 3x31, it's going to cost four breeders, and I'll show you why that's the case, but just trust me for now. Then if you want a 4x21, it's going to cost eight breeders, and then if you want a 5x31, it's going to cost 16 breeders, and if you want a 6x31, it's going to cost 32 breeders in order to make that happen. And that means quite a lot of breeding steps, but I'll get into that later. Other than that, I mean, there's nothing too complicated. And I'll show you how this graphical representation is useful later on in this video. Or actually, I'll make a new video. I'll just post this one up in the meantime so that you can digest this information right now. Just the very start of breeding. And then my next video is going to be, did you know that Ash is actually an incompetent fuck? It's true. He really is. He really is. He's quite bad at his job, and he's certainly not going to be as accomplished a breeder as any of you guys once you've finished this video series. So, be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, all that, because it helps tremendously. Hit that thumbs up, you know, on the video. I really appreciate it, and it'll definitely encourage me to make more content, because I like teaching, I like sharing things, but if I don't feel like people are interested in the stuff that I'm sharing, you know, what's the point? So thank you very much for tuning in, watching, listening, and learning, because learning is half the battle, the other half is literally practice. So comment anything that you'd like to learn about, anything that you've been curious about in PokeMMO that you think would make for a decent video in terms of tutorial. And I'll see you guys next time when I continue the breeding guide. All right, peace.